Hey guys, welcome to this video on arithmetic sequences and their formulas. Sequences typically have set patterns that enable us to predict what each term might be. A list of numbers ordered in a particular way is a sequence, and each individual number is referred to as a term. Understanding arithmetic sequences and how to identify them is a great way to develop critical thinking skills. Identifying how numbers relate to each other and what commonalities they have in a sequence can carry over into better critical thinking skills and other intellectual endeavors. An arithmetic sequence is a sequence or progression of numbers where the difference between each number is the same, or constant. For example, in this series, 5, 12, 19, and 26, we can tell that this is an arithmetic sequence by subtracting each number from the number following it. So 5 minus 12 equals negative 7, 12 minus 19 equals negative 7, and 19 minus 26 equals negative 7. The difference is the same each time, therefore it is a constant. In other words, to tell whether or not it is an arithmetic sequence, we need to be able to see what is happening between each number, and whatever happens between the two needs to be the same thing that is happening between each consecutive number. Another way to write this arithmetic sequence is A, A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D. The letter A represents the first term, and the letter D represents the constant difference. So, looking back at our sequence of numbers, let's apply this. 5, 12, 19, 26. Using this method, let's plug in our numbers. We have 5 as our first term, and we know that the constant difference is 7. 5, 5 plus 7, 5 plus 2 times 7, and 5 plus 3 times 7, which equals 5, 12, 19, and 26. What if we wanted to find the 50th term in the sequence? Let's write an arithmetic sequence as a formula. X sub n equals a plus d times n minus 1. The reason n minus 1 is used is because d, the constant difference, is not applied to the very first term. Let's take a look at a new arithmetic sequence and using our new formula calculate a certain term. Look at this sequence. 9, 17, 25, 33, 41, 49, 57, 65, 73, 81. So, we're going to calculate the fourth term using our formula. We know that our first term is 9, so now we have to calculate this constant difference, which is 8. So we're looking for our fourth term, which is represented by x sub 4. A is our first term, which is 9, d is our constant difference, which is 8, and n represents the number sequence order, which in this case is 4. So let's plug in our numbers. X sub 4 equals 9 plus 8 times 4 minus 1, which equals 33. Now, typically, you wouldn't use the formula to calculate a term that is already listed, but rather to predict and calculate a term farther along the progression of numbers. So let's say we wanted to calculate the 1,698th term of this arithmetic sequence. X sub 1,698 equals 9 plus 8 times 1,698 minus 1, which equals 13,585. I hope that this video was helpful. To check out more of our videos, be sure to subscribe to our channel. See you next time.